Trench Road International presents Dr. Paul Young Yee Cho's World Discovery, an exploration of today's Christian faith. Dr. Paul Young Yee Cho, pastor of the world's largest church in Seoul, Korea, where a vibrant Christian awakening is sparking a spiritual explosion around the world.
At night when I sleep, it's for about 3 hours, and then I wake up with excruciating pain in my back. And I believe and know that Jesus has healed me tonight. I can feel the warmth in that area right now as the Holy Spirit heals me. And tonight, I'll go home and sleep peacefully all night because of Jesus.
Yes, that's right. Praise the Lord. God bless you.
This week from the Oakland Convention Center in Oakland, California, the Greater Bay Area Full Gospel Businessmen's Fellowship presents A Message of Faith from Pastor Paul Cho of the Uido Full Gospel Church in Seoul, Korea, the largest church in the world, with a congregation nearing 400,000 members. Korea's spiritual revival is today moving hearts the world over. Through the ministry of Uido Full Gospel Church and Pastor Paul Cho, the gospel is touching every corner of the world in seminars, conferences, and telecasts. A Christian awakening is spreading from Seoul, Korea.
Pastor Young Yee Cho, World Mission Today.
Now, from the Oakland Convention Center in Oakland, California, Pastor Paul Cho brings a message on the good news for life from Isaiah chapter 61, verses 1 and 2.
Tonight, I want to speak about the gospel of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ came to this world to preach the good news because he himself was a good news. In this day, we are hearing bad news all over the world. Whenever we turn on television and radio, whenever we look at the newspaper, we find plenty of bad news all over the world. But when we come to Jesus Christ, we only hear good news. So tonight I want to speak about good news that Jesus Christ brought to our lives. When Jesus Christ returned to his hometown after having fasted and prayed for 40 days and 40 nights, he came in the power of the Holy Spirit. And on the Sabbath day, he came to the synagogue and people gave him the scroll of Isaiah. There, Jesus Christ opened the Isaiah to this scripture. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. And he closed the books and he gave it to again to the minister and sat down, and the eyes of all them that were in the synagogue were fastened on him. And he began to say unto them, this day is this scripture fulfilled in your ears. So tonight, I want to repeat that same good news to you. Many people ask me question, what is the gospel? What is the good news? What is the definition of gospel of Jesus Christ? Jesus Christ himself get definition to the audience in his hometown at the synagogue. Jesus Christ says, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. And number one, God has sent me to preach the good news to the poor. When God created Adam and Eve and let them dwell in the Garden of Eden, there were no vocabulary such as poverty, because they were abundantly furnished and prepared and blessed. Every day they were having such a beautiful spiritual fellowship with God, and what a rich fellowship they enjoyed. They had the faith, hope, love, peace, and joy, and all of those blessings were inundated in their lives because God walked with them hand in hand. What a rich spiritual blessing they had. And also, in their circumstances, physically, there were nothing lacking in the Garden of Eden because God provided everything abundantly. But when Adam and Eve fell in sin and rebelled against God, then instantly their fellowship was cut off. Their spirit was dead, and they could not have any more fellowship with Heavenly Father. So their spirit fell into utter poverty, because they lost the fellowship with God, and no more did they feel any presence of God. They were completely lost, and they could not taste the goodness of God, neither could they have the peace, joy, and faith, hope. Not only that they were chased out of God of Eden, and right away the earth was cursed because of them, and the earth began to produce thorns and the thistles, and wherever they went, they were walking and living upon the thorny patch. They were living under the curse. Wherever they turned around, they were cursed. Since that time up till now, humanity has been living under those poverties. Human beings are dual in their existence because we are spiritual beings. You are spirit. Your spirit is living in your physical body. Our spirit is made according to the image and likeness of God, and our spirit can never die. Whether we live in heaven with God or suffer in the hell with Satan, but our spirit will never be completely destroyed. So we are going to experience dual poverties. We are experiencing the spiritual poverty and then the physical, material poverty, because we have been living under the curse of God, under the judgment of God, because of rebellion. So, after the falling of Adam until Christ came, whole earth was cursed. And so people were suffering from dual poverties, spiritual poverty as well as material poverty. Then Jesus Christ came, and he came preaching the good news to the poor. This means that Christ brought the good news to the spiritual poverty as well as physical poverty. And when we receive Jesus Christ as our personal Savior, then through the suffering of Jesus Christ, you and I are going to be redeemed. We are redeemed from our past, present, and future sins. And we are rejoined through Jesus Christ to our Heavenly Father, and God gives eternal life, God's kind of life into our heart, and we can enjoy the fellowship with the Holy Spirit. Now in Christ Jesus, we have the peace, joy, hope, faith, and love. This is not religion. This is more than religion. Jesus Christ is the Son of God, the person. So when we believe in Jesus, we are not receiving any form of religion. We are receiving the Son of God. When Jesus comes, he enriches us so mightily that we know that we are accepted by God because the Holy Spirit witnessed so. I was born and raised up as a Buddhist. So till I become 18 years old, I was faithful Buddhist. We were faithfully attending the temple, and every morning I was worshiping Buddha with my father, chanting the prayer. But when I was struck with a terminal tuberculosis, and when doctor told me that I would only live more than 3 months, I became desperate. I was vomiting blood every day. I was delirious, dizzy. I felt the suffocating sensation every moment, and I became desperate. And one day, out of desperation, I gave a hope about Buddha. I began to cry to the unknown God, God, if there are God in the universe, please come and touch me and help me. But I did not dream that God would be Jesus Christ. In less than 1 week, one schoolgirl came bringing Bible to my home, and she began to tell me about Jesus. First, I turned down. For a little while, I was resisting, but finally, I was persuaded. Then I accepted her Bible and began to read four Gospels. There, I met Jesus Christ face to face. Christ was more than religion, more than philosophy. I met the person, Jesus Christ. He was going around forgiving the sins of sinners, healing the sick, casting out devil, raising the dead, and blessing the people. There I found out that Jesus Christ never hated sinner, but he hated sin. He never hated the sick, he hated sickness. He never hated the demon possessed, but he hated demons. He never hated the dead, he hated death. And by reading scripture, I found out that God loved this world so much that he gave his only begotten son. And Jesus Christ came to this world to become a friend to dying humanity. Jesus Christ was never enemy to any humanity. He was enemy to sin, enemy to sickness, enemy to devil, enemy to death, but he was friend to humanity. And tonight, he is friend to me and to you. When I prostrated before the cross of Jesus Christ, and when I uttered a very simple prayer, Jesus, I need you. If you are truly Son of God, please come and save me. Then I felt that some very strange sensation. Something would hit deep into the pit of my stomach, and my stomach began to churn up. But soon I felt such a feeling of glow, that glow began to spread all over my chest. Next moment, I felt that I was engulfed by Jesus Christ. Up till that time, I had never attended any church service. But by reading scripture, when I prayed that very simple prayer, Jesus came with a heavenly peace, and I was completely engulfed by the peace of Jesus Christ. And I did not feel any fear of death. All the feeling of wretchedness were lifted up, and I was full of the peace of Jesus Christ, and I knew that I was saved. That was the restoration of the fellowship. That was the richness of spiritual experience. When you come to Jesus, Christ is going to enrich your spiritual life. This kind of joy and peace and love you can purchase by your money or education. This is heavenly given through Jesus Christ. Not only that, when you live faithfully serving Jesus Christ, then God is going to bless even physically and materially. Because human beings were cursed and they were living on the patch of thorn, but Jesus Christ took all the curse away. Christ came to preach good news to the poverty-stricken, even physically and materially. This Bible says in Galatians 3rd chapter, verse 13 and 14, that Christ has delivered us from the curse of the law, for he was cursed himself. For Bible says, curses everyone who hangs on a tree, that the blessing of Abraham might come upon Gentiles through Jesus Christ. You and I are becoming the children of Abraham through faith in Jesus Christ. We are no more going to live under curse or on the cursed patch. We are going to live in the lands of Abraham, where milk and honey issues. Hallelujah. Not only that, when I read 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 9, the Bible so clearly declares that ye know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Though he was rich, yet for your sake he became poor, that ye in his poverty might be rich. How are you going to explain the scripture? Jesus says that the heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall never pass away. The Bible must stand. Christ has delivered us from the curse, because he himself is cursed in our place. Now we have got to claim the blessing of Abraham. In 1958, when I graduated from Bible college, and when I went out to pioneer my first church, I went to an utterly poor area, slum area. People were broken in spirit, soul, and body. They were living from hand to mouth. And they were so poor that I was at the loss as to what to do. And their God told me to preach this good news to them. If they would accept Jesus Christ and surrender their lives to Jesus, then Jesus not only would build them up spiritually, but build them up physically and materially. And I boldly preached this message to them. You know, this Bible says Christ came to preach good news. Good news is supposed to be heard and get the mind changed. You can't eat good news. You can't be closed up on good news. You can hear the good news and your consciousness can be changed. So many people are living under the consciousness of poverty. They are living in sin consciousness, poverty consciousness, failure consciousness. I cannot do consciousness. But when you hear this good news through Jesus Christ, your consciousness can be changed from poverty consciousness to the richness consciousness, from failure consciousness to success consciousness, from defeatism to the victory. Because Bible says, watch out your heart more than anything else. The issues of life are from that place. So before you get your mind changed, your thinking life changed, God can flow through you. Your negative thinking, impossibility, thinking, negative faith would blockade the flowing of the Holy Spirit. Because my Bible says God is going to do exceeding abundantly above all what you ask or think. So tonight, you have enough foundation to get your thinking life changed. Because God has come to change your thinking life through Jesus Christ. What Jesus Christ took away, you should not carry anymore. Jesus took your curse away. Jesus took your failure away through the cross so that you may have something to share with the dying world. We are not asking God to bless us so that we may enjoy by ourselves. We are asking blessing of God spiritually, materially, so that we may share with the underprivileged dying people in the world. Number two, Jesus Christ said, I came to heal the brokenhearted. We are all brokenhearted people. You look at your neighbor. You look at the whole nation, the whole world. We are all broken people. When Adam and Eve rebelled against God, since that time until now, we have been living a broken life by the fear, hatred, wretchedness, and by condemnation. We are broken people. This is reason. Since broken people are living in this society, homes are getting broken, society are getting broken, and the whole world is going to be blown up by the hatred. Who can heal? New legislation? More education? More technology? Well, we have been seeking that. We have been quite successful around that area. But those things never brought healing to the brokenhearted. Only Jesus Christ can heal our brokenhearted. When I was preaching in Japan, I met a wonderful couple. They came out on my television show in Japan and they publicly testified. This gentleman was too much in drinking habit and gambling. But he really loved his last son. One day he was playing with his last son, but suddenly he was violently insane. And when he came in his right mind, he found out that he strangled his last son to death. He was sitting on the dead body of his last son. He was so shocked. He couldn't stand any more. He surrendered himself to the police station. And he asked authority to put him on an electric chair. But the court, having considered all the plight, they only sentenced him for 10 years in imprisonment. For 10 years he was serving in prison, but every moment he was hating himself. And he would not even meet any of his family or relative when they come to visit him. He cursed his life. He wanted to die. And 10 years passed, and he was released from prison. And he gathered whatsoever he had and bundled up, and he came back home. His wife came out and welcomed him, but he didn't even answer. But whole town turned out. They said, the killer of his son came. So they chased him out of town. So he and his family came out from that town to the Osaka, the second largest city in Japan. He found a job, but every day he wanted to die. He cursed himself. Every moment he could see the face of his last son. He was so wonderful to him. And he couldn't forgive himself. He said, I should be punished. I should be destroyed. So every day he was drinking, and then he would go to the slot machine, and he would spend all the money on slot machine. And one day it was raining, and he was so depressed. He wanted to commit suicide. He was walking on the back alley of the Osaka city. Suddenly he heard some gospel song. So he followed after the song, and he entered into a small mission. There are dozens of people who are singing. Then a preacher stood up, and he began to preach the love of Jesus Christ. Redemption grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. He was deeply impressed. And when the preacher called the salvation message, those who want to be saved, when he called the sinner to come out, he was the first one who stood up and rushed out. And he opened his heart. Jesus, can I be forgiven? Jesus, could you take this feeling of condemnation away from my heart? Then love of God poured upon him. And blood of Jesus Christ came and cleansed his heart. There, first time in 10 years, he felt completely released from the condemnation. He felt so clean. He felt so buoyant and joyful. He jumped up and he danced. He said, I'm released. I'm released. I'm clean. Then there he ran to his house. And he hugged his wife first time in 10 years. And he said, I'm saved. Jesus came into my heart. I'm healed. My broken heart is healed. Now I can love you because Jesus Christ put love in my heart. He hugged his wife. He loved his wife. He hugged all of his children. And they cried and loved them. And the whole family was completely healed that day by the love of Jesus Christ. Praise God. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever, even this evening. He's reaching out his nail-scarred hand to touch you, to love you, and to heal your broken heart. Are you broken? You can be healed. Then you can become the means of healing to your husband, wife, children, and neighbor.
Be sure to be with us next week for the conclusion of Pastor Paul Show's message on the Good News for Life.
Pastor Yonggi Cho, World Mission Today.
I pray that my message was a blessing to you. In 1958, when God first called me out to pioneer work in the suburb of Seoul City, I dreamed to have a church which has 150 members. That was my uttermost goal. Beyond that, I couldn't even visualize. But as I worked very hard, God began to work through my ministry. And in 2 years, I had 150 members. Then God increased my visions and dream. I dreamed for 600. By 1961, I had 600. Then God increased my faith even greater way. I dreamed for 3,000. And by 1964, God blessed me with 3,000 souls. You see, if you work for the Lord and exercise your faith, then God is going to increase your faith in visions and dreams. Since that time, God gave me the visions and dream to build the largest church in the world, and I wanted to have 500,000 members. And I've been dreaming upon that goal. I've been eating, living, sleeping, waking up with that vision because I was pregnant with that visions and dream. And I was incubating upon that visions and dream day in, day out. Just like a hen sitting upon the eggs dreaming for the chicken. I've been sitting upon that eggshell goal, and I've been incubating and incubating, praying and praising and believing. And finally, God's power came upon me, and now we are arriving at 500,000 members. Then, God is giving me another vision to lead 10 million Japanese souls to Jesus Christ. By your prayer and support, I believe that we can accomplish this goal for God's glory. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that you are blessing me, rest upon richly on this brother and sister, and raise them up as a mighty warrior for Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.